Hello class, this is Ms. Friggin. Today's video on sequences. Shout out to Hayan, who just left my desk so that I can start filming this video. Sequences is a topic that you're going to see often in calculus and beyond. So it's a really very easy topic, well at least initially. Okay. Anyway, so let's take a look at an example. Here we have a collection of numbers, and that's what sequences are in their order from increasing to decreasing. I mean, from one number to increasing or from one number to decreasing. It really does depend. And if we take a look here, we can see that if you do some simple math, you can see that to go from 2, negative 2 to 3 is 5, 3 to 8 is 5, 8 to 13 is 5. 13 to 18 is 5, and vice versa. Well, this is a special type of sequence, which is, again, it is a collection of ordered numbers, but all of the ordered numbers, the consecutive numbers, differ by 5. So this is called an arithmetic sequence because the consecutive numbers differ. Consecutive means one right after the other. So this is an arithmetic sequence, and the difference, D, is equal to 5. The first term is negative 2, and we call the first term of a sequence the initial term, and we indicate it by the name of the letter of the sequence, let's call it A, and the subscript represents the order. This is the first one, and this is the second one. 8 is the third one. And vice versa. So I use a lot of terminology, so let's take a look at this terminology. A sequence, the definition, is an ordered list of numbers, terms. And in an example, the letter sequence, and we usually initially label a sequence with the letter A. So the first term is A sub 1, the second term is A sub 2, and vice versa. Now what the values of the terms are, it depends on the sequence, but they're usually any type of number, but it has to be in order of either increasing or decreasing order. And the nth term is what we call the general term, in which we use to come up with some type of formula to determine how to calculate the next term. I just spoke about an arithmetic sequence. And an example that I showed you is a sequence where the difference between pairs of consecutive terms is a fixed quantity. So another way to identify the sequence by the general term is by putting curly brackets to represent the sequence, and the individual terms, i.e. the numbers in the sequence, are represented by the letter A with a little index. So this refers here, if I want to figure out what the next term in the sequence is after this term, I just add the common difference, which is D. And as we saw in our problem, if I wanted to figure out what the answer was after, I forgot what number that was, let's see, after 28, to figure out what the answer was after 28, I could use this formula to figure it out. If you remember, the common difference was 5. And the previous term was 28. So to figure out the next term, we add it and we get the next term after 28 would be 33. So if 28 was the sixth term, or A sub 6, then 33 would be A sub 7 because that's one more than 6. Let's take a look at some other sequences. Okay, here we have the initial term is, as you can see, 21. So we're going to call this, we can call the sequence B. So this is B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, and the dot 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 means it can go on forever and ever. So my question is for this problem, what is D? What is the common difference between any two consecutive terms? 32 to 37, the difference is 5. To go from this one to get to 37, I add 5 to 32. And I can use this to figure out the other one. Take a look at another sequence. Now here, we have a sequence of values that are not whole numbers. So in this sequence, and I'm going to call it C, my C1, my initial term is 0.3, my C2 is 1.4, my C3 is 2.5. So to figure out C4, I take wherever C3 is and add D. Well, I know that my C3 is 2.5, but then my D, well, I haven't figured that out yet. If I take a look here, to go from 0.3 to 1.4 is 1.1. To go from 1.4 to 2.5 is 1.1. So that means my common difference is 1.1. And to figure out the next answer, I add these together and I get my next answer will be, yes, 3.6. Now, maybe I would say this is really simple, but this is an arithmetic sequence, and the arithmetic sequences do start off simply. Important things to note is that the sequences don't necessarily have to have positive and whole numbers. As you can see here, we have negative numbers in the terms, and we have decimal values in the terms. And we could go all day talking about that. But what does have to be a positive whole number are the indices. And the indices are the subscripts. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now some of you may be saying this looks very similar to a linear equation. And it actually is. The only difference is that instead of taking any value for x, we take x such that x is a whole counting number. So it starts at 1, 2, 3, da 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 da. In some books, sometimes they start off the initial term is with 0, but your book starts it off with 1. So not all sequences are arithmetic. There are other types of sequences as well. And this second type of sequence that we're going to look at is called a geometric sequence. If arithmetic means to add a common difference to get the next term, what do you think geometric sequences are? And this is just repeating what we already talked about. A geometric sequence is a sequence where each term is a constant multiple of the preceding term. So instead of adding the preceding term to get the next term, we multiply it. And so to figure out that common constant multiple, we take the ratio of consecutive terms. And that will be the common multiple. So let's take a look at an example of that. So here we have another sequence, and I want to clarify something. The numbers don't always have to be in order, and I'm going to show you an example where they're not always in order, but they're ordered in the sense that they follow the pattern to determine the next number. So in this case, as you can see, we can add, if we try and take a look at the differences, we see that we don't get the same answer. And vice versa. So this cannot be an arithmetic sequence because they don't have the same difference. But if we want to take a look at dividing previous terms by one another, we do seem to get something. So if I take 9 divided by 3, I get 3. And if I get 27 divided by 3, I'm sorry, divided by 9, because they have to be a pair, I get 3 as well. And if I get 81 divided by 27, I get 3. And if I get 143 divided by 81, I get 3 as well. So in this case, they don't have a common difference, but they do have a common ratio, and that common ratio simplifies to 3. So this is a geometric sequence because they have a common ratio. And to figure out the next term, all I have to do is multiply the previous term, let's call it A sub n, times 3, and then I will get A sub n plus 1. So that leads us to back to our notes, where we take a look at how to calculate a value. They basically raise in the previous one. Oh, let me clarify the previous value. is equal to a sub n minus 1 times the common ratio. But what if I don't know what the previous value is, and all I know is the original value? Or another way to define that, to figure out a sub n, is take the initial value and multiply it times a power of the common ratio. And that power is n minus 1. And we'll take a look in class on why that's the case. And before I forget, if you want to figure out the next term in the arithmetic sequence, I talked about just adding the previous value, adding that common distance to that. But if you don't know the previous value, another way you can do it is by taking the initial term and adding a multiple of the common difference. And we'll talk about why that multiple is an n minus 1 in both situations. So that's all, folks.